Good afternoon. Before getting into today's topic, I tell them that you have linked contract concept and classification and requirement of the contract. In the 10th video of my channel, I will talk about the V's of the contract. What are the V's of a contract? The high element that prevent the contract from being properly formed. Then I divide it into two. V's of consent and V's of the cause. We begin to set them. First, I will tell you what they consist of and then what effects they have on the contract made with this V's. V's of the consent. They are subdivided into error, violence and intimidation and dolo. Error. Error vice, ostentatory error or low error. Error vice. It is the false representation of reality. In order for the contract to be visited, it must be essential to follow an essential element of the contract and excusable, which cannot be attributed to the person suffering from it. I will explain invalidating error and other that are not. Invalidating error. Error on the substance or quality, but on the main quality that individualized it or was composed. It also the condition that led to healing. Error on the person. When what leads to healing, it's not the substance, but the person or his qualities. Error on the existence of the object. The contract was made on an object which has never really existed or been destroyed, clearly missing the essential requirement of the object. No invalidating errors. Error about the weight, the extension, or the quantity, since the interested party had wanted to have been able to check them. Error on the value. If it is not being caused by the other party, if the other party provokes it, it will not be an error, but a flaw, which I will deal with later. Error on the reason. Internal or personal reason and never taking on to account. Ostentative error. This type of error happens when the contract is badly written or when we are wrong to say or write. In order for the contract to expire, it must meet the same requirement as the error vice, so I refer to what has been said about it before. Low error. This occurs when it affects the legal quality of the object of the contract. The requirement for the contract to be concluded at the same as the previous one. In an indication of error, the one who alleges it is the one who must prove it. Violence and intimidation. Violence, consent to a person he started using an irresistible force which serves to intimidate that person, it is totally different if such violence is exercised by the counterpart of the contract or by a third party. Intimidation. It must comply the following requirement. The threat of a prior and real evil to consent. Say evil must be imminent, serious, and concrete. And in addition, there must be a relationship between the threat and the business. It can go directly to the contractor or any of the people in your family or friends. The contractor must suffer a rational and well-founded fear to assess this. The personal circumstance of each contractor will be taken into account. Fraud. It is a scam through words to induce someone to hide. It must complete the following requirements. Seriously. You must have enough strength to achieve this scam. It must come from the other party. The third party intent is irrelevant. But if there is a relationship between the third party and the party, it will also be considered dolo, serious and decisive. If it occurs on no essential element, it doesn't beat it. If both parties commit the fraud, they are compensated and the contract remains valid. There is an omissive fraud The content is also vetted. It occurs when a person takes advantage of the circumstance of the third party that caused fraud. Then it also the dolus bonus is doesn't vetted the contract since it's a margin of error allowed by the society. Base of the cause. The cause is the purpose of the contract. This is subdivided into inexistent. The contract which occurs is totally null or non-existent. False of the cause. The cause of the contract is not that, but is another. If it is proven that it is founded on a dollar law for and true one, the nullity of the contract will not occur. Illicit cause. Said cause is contrary to law, morality, or public order. Difference between the vis of consent and the vis of cause. The difference lies in the legal effect of the contract. If they are the vis of consent, the contract will be voidable. If they are the vis of the cause, the contract is void. I hope you like today's video. See you in the next one, in which I will discuss the facts of the contract. Until next week.